Have you ever considered purchasing hearing aids on Amazon? Well, in this video, we'll take a look and listen to some of the top options. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Steve Taddei from HearingTracker, and in this video, we are taking a look at four hearing aids that you can purchase on Amazon. And at the time of this review, these were the top four rated hearing aids by Amazon based on their sales. So we'll take a look at the differences between these four products, how they performed in our lab, and you'll even be able to hear them for yourself compared to one of the latest prescription hearing aids from a major hearing aid manufacturer. Before we get too far, we are constantly releasing new content like this at HearingTracker. So don't forget to subscribe if you'd like to stay up to date. So without further delay, let's take a look at our lineup. In not any specific order, we have the Audien Hearing Atom, the EarCentric Easy Charge Hearing Aid, the Autiphon U0 Series, and the HSKlock Premium Digital Hearing Aid. As a quick disclaimer, all of these devices claim to be actual hearing aids, meaning they're supposedly medical devices designed to compensate for hearing impairment. With that said, it's often impossible to verify such claims due to the prevalence of white labeling, where the brand name being sold doesn't match the brand name on record with the FDA. Now, our research suggests that many online hearing aids are registered with the FDA under a different brand name. But in some cases, there's no registration at all. And in these cases, companies would technically be breaking the law by calling their product a hearing aid, because these devices then would actually be considered personal sound amplification products. And FDA rules state that such products cannot be sold as a solution for hearing loss. But technicalities aside, that's why we're testing these devices. How do they compare to a traditional hearing aid? Lastly, none of these devices were programmable based on a hearing test, so we did our best to match their output to a standard hearing loss configuration. Starting with Audien Hearing, you'll find user manuals, the charging base, and two in-the-ear style hearing devices. A USB-C cable and wall plug are included along with extra ear domes, wax guards, a cleaning tool, and a cloth carrying case. Once out of the box, the devices need to be charged, which can take up to 4 hours. Audien Atom magnetically lock in the charging base and an LED turns green when they're ready, giving you up to 20 hours of battery life per charge. These devices do have an on-off switch and a small volume dial, which can be adjusted using the tool end of the cleaning brush. Atom have only one program and no other settings are adjustable. Next up, we have EarCentric hearing aids. In the box, you'll again find some help documents, a charging base, and two rechargeable behind-the-ear style devices. A USB cable and wall plug are included along with a hard shell case. Lastly, various cleaning supplies, extra tubes, and a few extra domes are included. EarCentric hearing aids magnetically lock in the base and can take up to 3 hours to fully charge. Once ready, they claim to have a battery life up to 22 hours. These devices have both a multi-function button and volume switch. A long press of the button will power the devices on or off, while a short press will switch between either an everyday or speech and noise program. The Autiphon U0 series is next, including user guides and a charging case with two rechargeable in-the-ear style devices. A USB cable is included, though unlike the others, you'll need to use your own wall plug. Lastly, you'll find a few accessories such as extra domes, wax guards, and a cleaning brush. As with all the other devices so far, Autiphon magnetically locks in the base and will take roughly 2 hours to charge. These claim to have a whopping 50-hour battery life, and the charging base is unique as it doubles as both a carrying case and a portable charger. Autiphon has a rotary volume dial, but unfortunately there is no program button or on-off switch. Last in our lineup are the HSKlock hearing aids. In the box, you'll find a short operation manual and two hard shell cases housing the behind-the-ear style devices. Batteries and extra domes are included. Unlike the other devices discussed so far, these are not rechargeable and require disposable batteries, which can be inserted into a swivel battery door on the bottom of the device. Furthermore, while multiple programs are not available, you will find both an on-off switch and rotary volume dial. Lastly, while these devices appear to be of a traditional behind-the-ear style, the speaker is actually located down in the earpiece. So now that we're more familiar with these devices, let's listen to them. First up, we'll be hearing these devices in a quieter library setting. We'll progress through each Amazon device, ending with one of the latest prescription hearing aids from a major hearing aid manufacturer. In each of these sequences, you'll first hear what it sounds like without any hearing device. So this will be a good control and allow you to set your headphone volume at a level that sounds normal and appropriate to you. Once you get a good headphone volume, it's best not to adjust it as we go through these. One final comment before we hit play. For our recordings, we attempted to adjust the hearing devices to meet the needs of someone with a mild to moderate hearing loss, which is a very common type of age-related hearing loss. To hear your best with this type of hearing injury, it's important that a hearing aid provide adequate high-frequency amplification. So while you're listening to these sound samples, remember that what sounds best from a sound quality perspective may not align with what provides the greatest benefit to speech clarity. You may have experienced this if you've been fit with hearing aids by a hearing care professional. Everything may have sounded unnatural and overly bright initially, but over time you acclimatize and retrain your brain to hear in a more natural way. So keep that in mind as we go through these and stick around until the end to hear my assessment of the results and more information on how we set up these devices.
Solids, liquids, gases. I mean, don't get me started on the periodic table.
Although Mrs. Barnes did have a way of teaching, I mean, I even remember her jokes. Oxidants
happen. Don't overreact. I guess all that studying worked. I remember the mnemonic aid for orbitals.
Sober physicists don't find giraffes hiding in kitchens.
Now let's move to a more difficult setting that has more noise and talkers. We'll go through the same exact progression.
When was the last time you had pasta this good?
Well, it's not only the pasta, your chicken is tasty too. The breading stays on and
it has a nice crunch.
Oh yeah, that'd be great. I'm not much of a chef, but if you think it's doable, I'll try it.
You'll be fine. I bet you'll be shocked how easy it is to make it taste so good. You really can.
It's just some seasoning, eggs, flour, water, rest of the oil, and bread.
Hey, I'll take it too. We'll have us all making chicken parmesan for our parties.
Lastly, let's hear how music sounds with these devices. And to clarify, this is not streamed audio, as none of these Amazon devices were Bluetooth capable. This was music being picked up by the hearing aids as though you're listening to a stereo system in your car or home. There's a lot that can be said after hearing those samples. All of these Amazon devices can be purchased for less than $200, while that final sample in each setting was a traditional hearing aid that would be sold for thousands of dollars at a clinic. Now, I have my own opinions about these devices and how they performed, but I would love to hear your thoughts on which ones you liked, did they help make speech clear in background noise, and did they sound good with music? After testing the Amazon devices, it was clear that none of them provided adequate amplification to significantly improve clarity. This was clear from our measurements showing little to no usable gain above roughly 1000 Hz. And that's the region where the majority of speech clarity comes from and arguably tied to the number one complaint individuals with hearing loss have. The medical hearing aid, however, did a much better job of amplifying those high frequencies, which you may have noticed through the extra brightness or crispness in those sound samples. Hopefully you were able to pick up on that difference, but if not, feel free to rewind the video and listen again. Another important element to discuss were the available adjustments and how we program these devices for testing. For the Amazon products, I feel as though we pretty much maximized their capabilities for these tests. Adjustments were limited to the single volume knob. We also didn't see much difference when switching between available programs for noise reduction. So what we ultimately did was match their volume as best as we could to the NAL NL2 1000 Hz 65 dB input target for an N3 hearing loss. Now, if you're not familiar with targets, NAL NL2 refers to the most commonly used amplification prescription, and it basically tells hearing aids how much volume to provide at each frequency for any given hearing loss. 1000 Hz was chosen as the Amazon devices did not provide much gain above this range. And lastly, N3 refers to a standard moderate sloping hearing loss configuration. So it corresponds to what many people experience, where there is greater injury in the higher ranges of hearing, making it difficult to hear speech clearly. For the medical hearing aid, however, the device was set similar to what you may experience at a typical hearing aid fitting, meaning we did not optimize the medical hearing aid. We chose to do this as most hearing care providers fail to run amplification verification procedures, such as real ear measurements, which optimize benefit. So to be consistent with this, we programmed the devices to an N3 hearing loss using an NAL NL2 prescriptive formula, manufacturer recommended ear coupling was used, feedback calibration was completed, and it was left in an automatic program. We did not perform any other real ear measurements, but the device was left at the prescribed volume, which is also known as 100% acclimatization. What this means is that there were still many physical and programming adjustments that could be made based on an individual's preferences and needs. Regarding the sound samples and our test setup, the dialogue you heard was recorded at a college audio facility with voice talent. The environmental sounds came from the Ambisonics Recordings of Typical Environments database. These files were decoded and played back over our system along with the dialogue we recorded using a MATLAB program. For our test setup, an Antelope Orion Studio audio interface feeds 8 Yamaha HS5 powered speakers. A Keemar mannequin is used to record sound back into our audio interface. Keemar, the speakers, and the presented audio are all calibrated. The room is both sufficiently quiet and dampened as most surfaces have several inches of acoustic absorption. There's much more to our test setup and we'll have more information available on that shortly. To summarize everything in this video, the HearingTracker team was honestly very surprised by the results of these tests. Quite frankly, we were hoping for better outcomes when it came to the Amazon products. But not all hearing technology is equal, and that's why we're dedicated to keeping you up to date and informed in this expanding landscape. So if you found this video helpful, stay with us and hit that subscribe button. Also, let me know in the comments below if you've tried any other devices like these and how they worked for you. But that's it for this video, so I'll see you next time.